Hey yo together and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replays today with a TVT on Nimbus LE. And as you can see, it's a Diamond versus a Grandmaster player, and for all who doesn't know it, this is the Smurf of 4GG. BAMS! And yeah, I will talk about that later after the replay. But for now, just enjoy the game. We got 4GG, or at least bad boards I should say. So yeah, let's do the introduction. Let us do this the introduction. We got at the right bottom corner of Nimbus LE the blue Protoss bad boards, the blue Terran bad boards. It's not a Protoss. I know I was casting a lot of Protoss TVPs lately, but this guy is not playing Protoss. He's playing Terran. So blue Terran, red bottom corner bad boards. Smurf for 4GG. Right, his opponent me, the red Terran. Spawning at the right top corner of Nimbus LE, Alex Sasha. Alex Sasha, holy, nothing is going right here. Okay, standard opening so far. I would say we see a supply depot being made. For me, we see gas first, and for bad boards, we see nothing so far. Maybe he will get on. Where is his? Oh, he's playing. Okay. So bad boards, AK for GG, I would say. Maybe it seems he's playing. Yeah, command center first, definitely command center first against gas first, and that's so difficult, I would say, because gas first means normally aggression, fast, high tech aggression, not battle cruiser high tech, but Banshee, Raven, something like that. And with command center first, you have not a whole lot of gas income early in the game, so you have no tag. What you do is rely on bunkers and marines to defend. Bunker, turrets, marines, everything which costs minerals. He is annoying me a little bit there, but has to back off. Isn't able to deal real damage there. And we see the barracks. You see the command center morphing into an orbital command. A little more of damage is being shared here, and the factory as well as the marine, which is so late. And yeah, we see finally the barracks, 16 barracks, no, 15 barracks, 15 barracks, 16 barracks, something like that. Of course, it's two barracks, okay, two barracks. We see two barracks come down, and he saw gas first. I mean, the factory at minute 3 is definitely gas first. I guess he hasn't checked for that one, but he doesn't need to. He knows what he's up against. And yeah, he can produce a lot of SCVs, so if he is forced to pull some SCVs, he can also afford to do so. And we see a third barracks as well. So he's going really marine heavy against the composition I'm going for. And yeah, the second gas is coming down. We should see attack level really soon on that factory. There we go. Nice. And morphing this command center in orbital. Still no gas is taken. And I'm really interested in how he wants to defend that. Yeah, he's going for mass marines, I would say. Mass marines, and so far, supply-wise, he's a bit behind. Still up behind in worker, but this will change as he got the double mule production, the double SCV production now. I think he should maybe soon take some gases. You wanna get Stim. At least Stim could help a lot. But for now he's just producing marines, and we see the Raven, the Hellion and the Marines, so basic stuff. He's clearing those rocks, and I'm not sure why. But maybe he assumes me going for tanks or anything then, and he doesn't want to be forced to move down the ramp through this little choke. And we see the Hellion moving out for some scouting. Still no gas is taken. We see an engineering bay. I guess for Banshee that would be too late. Finally the gas is taken there. He's really nice spending his money, so he got not a whole lot of over minerals. He got no supply caps at all so far. He will be able to produce turrets now, and he scanned and saw the lifting of the starport. And my base is finally coming down as well. And now I know with the Hellion where he is. Not what he got, but where he is. And this debris finally taken out. Took so long. And yeah, he's producing some missile turrets. He's expecting Banshees. Not sure why. I mean, it's too late. Those turrets would be too late, I guess. And he's moving out with the Marines. Wants maybe to... to deal with the Banshee to catch it. Doesn't get it. And I see with the Hellion that many Marines. You know, okay, Marines are not too good against tanks and Marines and a Raven with PDD, with auto turret and Seeker missile. And those tech labs are finished, but he can't research Stim or Comet Shields because he got no gas for it. So I would say that Bad Borns is not playing as good as he could. And he's moving in there right now, and that's ballsy. Oh, a lot of Marines are going in there. But there are auto turrets and they are dealing quite nicely. Focusing this medivac, but nice micro there. And he loses a lot. If you look there, he loses a lot. And he can't trade there. He gets the medivac, almost gets the Raven, but at what cost? At what cost? If you look at the army supply, it's looking very bad. And dropping over those Marines to clear those with the help of the Hellion, he will lose all those Marines. Is able to kill one more Marine, but now he's in a pretty rough spot. He got three Marines. They are rallying the ramp here. He will lose those. And he got a lot of SCVs, but this lead is not too much. I mean, three mules is nice, but he needs to defend. He got no bunker, no factory. Stim is not ready. Combat is not ready. He's producing more. Oh, look at that. He's spending his money that's not queue up like that. And that don't queue up like that. That's bad. Definitely bad. He's pulling those SCVs and gets the medivac there. The tank is dealing some damage. Friendly fire on those Marines, but there's a second tank behind that. And he's losing a ton of SCVs there. And now he should be behind in SCVs. And still not defended. This auto turret not dealing too much damage. Auto turrets are nice for support. Oh, dropping there. This turret is still key for him, but it will fall eventually. And now it's looking very bad. He's so far behind in supply. And in workers, and in tech, and in everything. So this build not paying off so far. Behind that, more barracks are coming down. And I'm pushing in with tanks and everything. Nice stutter step micro there. And he may lose this eventually. Oh, nice save with the Marines. Loses the Marauder there as well. Can't really deal with that pressure and is so far behind now. I guess... Oh, he's losing the fact at the barracks there. Pulling even more SCVs. But he's too far behind. He can't afford to lose any SCV now. But he has to clear that. He has to clear that. He may get the siege tank there. Yes, he does. But at what cost? Losing this Marauder as well again. And the Raven is coming back. The Raven will be able to throw down an auto turret there. And 11 supply against 70. That's not good. Not really good there. And there he goes. GG. And now to the explanation why I was able to defeat 4GG. I guess it wasn't 4GG playing. Because first again, he's currently ranked 2 Grandmaster or anything like that. He won, it was I think DreamHack or Intel Extreme Masters. He's a real professional who's playing a lot. And there are some facts which show me that it wasn't playing, that 4GG wasn't playing. For example, the timing of the tech labs, that he wasn't able to produce them in combat shields at the time when they finished. Of course, that he lost. And how he played. I mean, he had no real multitasking, I guess. Not really. And yeah. I know that this account is shared, so Badboards, the account Badboards is shared. 4GG is playing sometimes on it, but there is a Master Zerg playing with this account as well, and I guess he just played Terran this time, and it wasn't really playing 4GG. But, if you are Diamond, you can maybe play sometimes against 4GG, maybe, sometimes, because 4GG is of course streaming a lot, playing a lot on this account as well, and when the Master League player pushed this account down to Diamond MMR again, and 4GG is playing with this account to play it up again, so there is a chance for Diamond players on Europe, I guess. Yeah, it was Europe, to play against 4GG, so If you wanna play 4GG, go Diamond, play a lot, and maybe you will be able to play against 4GG, which is so sick in my opinion. If you are able to play versus 4GG, I would have loved to play versus 4GG in this game. I know I would have lost, but it would be so cool to lose versus 4GG. Oh yeah. Okay, so thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I really need a break now. So yeah, thanks for watching. I wish you a very nice day. I hope we see us next time.